I'm joined by a counterterrorism expert, former Navy SEAL, and FBI Special Agent Jonathan Gilliam. Jonathan, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
You got it, buddy. It's always good to talk to you.
Yeah, you as well. And all right, so you heard that last caller. I guess I have two questions for you, Jonathan. Number one, on the embassy communication, you know, my takeaway was your takeaway, which was, wow, the State Department has done an awful, awful job. Let's touch that subject really quick first before we get to Syria.
Yeah, and I've heard nobody talk about that on TV at all. This is the first time I've actually heard anybody talk about it, and I guess because you had a personal experience with it. But it's really shocking that I actually saw the ambassador in an interview, and it was the most pompous and arrogant interview I've basically ever seen by a politician.
Really?
After a major crisis. Oh, it was, you know, it was just a terrible interview. But
this is the American ambassador to France.
The American ambassador to France. Just saw it yesterday, I think. And she was talking about all the stuff that the State Department was doing and that the embassy was doing. And I'm sitting here kind of in awe because you and I had been texting back and forth trying to figure this out when all this is going down. And, you know, it really signifies the problem that we have, not only in the State Department, but in all of politics now, where it's gotten to a point where leadership is so bad that I'm not even sure they're aware of the reality of how bad things are.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. I think the fact that they were feeding the same number to the media to tell parents to call, and, you know, as you and I talked about, I'm on the line with parents and who are on the line with their kids and, you know, just trying to help. And no one could solve that problem Friday night. I mean, it's just it's inexcusable is what it is. Someone has to be held accountable.
Exactly. And in this day and age, that should not be the case.
Right. Right. Should be understood that you can get in touch with the embassy during a time of crisis. All right. Let's switch gears. Talk about Syria. I've had some folks this morning say, well, you got some Syrian folks that are already in the country. But as you know, Governor Christie stood up with about 20 other governors and said, hey, we're not going to let Syrian refugees in. I pointed out that there are major allies of ours in major Muslim countries like Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, that will not let Syrian refugees into their country for fear of terrorism. Do you think the governor's making the right call? And, you know, why are these Syrian refugees a potential security threat?
So did Christie stand up and say no?
He did. He had an interview with Hugh Hewitt yesterday, and he said that we should not let any more Syrian refugees into this country.
Well, I totally agree with him. I think it's interesting how it took an attack in France.
Yeah.
And see, this is exactly what I'm talking about when it comes to who people vote for president of the United States. Chris Christie is just now, and all these other states are just now using this to push back and say, we don't want refugees, and for the right reasons. But what was the difference last week than it is this week? There was an attack in France. Is that what woke these people up and to tell them that there was going to be?
That they did step up to take this opportunity and say, okay,
no, I'm glad too.
It's in your face now. But what's the real threat, Jonathan? What are we missing here in America?
Well, two things are the biggest threat. One is a misconception of the reality of what terrorism is and the people that are trying that want to carry terrorism out. You know, terrorism is a tactic. It's not a people. And it's a tactic that is used to change the political ideology of another culture. And in this case, it's fundamental Islam, and they're trying to change the culture of the entire free world.
That's right.
The other problem we have in this country is the fact that what you just said, politics is based on reaction, and we need to have leaders that say, we're not letting Syrian refugees in because ISIS is going to infiltrate through them and get here.
And clearly that happened in Paris. That's exactly what happened. Yeah, I agree. All right, Jonathan, I gotta jump to take a break, but thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. I always appreciate your analysis on security, and I think you're right. There is a fundamental disconnect with politicians today, both in their function and in their attitude. The idea that you don't have many even able to utter the words Islamic extremism is a first sign of a problem. Thanks for taking the time with me this morning.